Shri Guru Bhyo Namaha.
Sound check.
Sound check, am I audible? Hello. Good evening, Kanchana. Am I audible? Will you do a quick
yes.
sound check? Shri Guru Bhyo Namaha. Thank you, Kanchana, for the introduction. And a very good evening to one and all who are watching me live on Facebook. Shri Mysore Vasudeva Acharya, who is also popularly called as Abhinava Tyagaraja, can be considered as one of the most popular and prominent Vagyayakaras that the 20th century has seen. He was born in May 1865 in an Orthodox Madhva Brahmin family to Shri Subramaniacharya and Srimati Krishnabai. Shri Subramaniacharya himself was a very great Sanskrit scholar and also a musician. Unfortunately, Shri Subramaniacharya died at a very young age, and the 3-year-old Vasu took shelter under his maternal grandfather, Shri Gopalacharya. He initially learned Sanskrit under the tutelage of Periyaswami Tirumalacharya and later in the Maharaja Sanskrit College. However, young Vasudevacharya's heart was in music. He really wanted to pursue music. That was his burning desire. So he finally convinced his grandfather on the pretext that he just wanted to tune simple shlokas and sing them in appropriate ragas. And he started learning music under the tutelage of Shri Subbaraya Shastri, who was also his neighbor. Later, he learned music from Vidwan Vine Padmanabhaya. Now, there is one very interesting and important incident that changed the entire direction of Shri Mysore Vasudevacharya's professional journey. There was a very prominent Diwan in Mysore who was called as Sheshagiri Ayyar. And there was a family wedding, an event, a grand event. And in those days, it was celebrated lavishly, and he had apparently invited Shri Patnam Subramaniam Ayyar and Shri Mahavaidyanath Ayyar, the two great legends in Carnatic classical music, to give concerts during the wedding festival. For the very first time, the young Vasu listened to both the legends and he was totally mesmerized. And he made up his mind that if he learned music, that would only be under the tutelage of Shri Patnam Subramaniam Ayyar. However, he was not financially too sound. So he had an idea. What he did was, he thought he would approach the great Vadayar and request him for a scholarship. In those days, Mysore King Chamarajendra Vadayar IX used to visit the Chamundeshwari temple on the Chamundi hills on every Tuesdays and Fridays and offered his prayers to the goddess there. So every Tuesdays and Fridays, the young Vasu would wait for the Maharaja to come and he would offer his pranams to him. This continued week on week, for several weeks, almost for almost 6 months he did this with a lot of perseverance and patience. And finally, one day, Maharaja stopped and he asked young Vasu, what is the reason that every week he is waiting for him and what is it that he wants, what is it that he aspires? And when he came to know the true reason, he was so generous that he immediately sanctioned him a scholarship, and Shri Mysore Vasudevacharya was able to relocate to Tiruvayyaru, and his rigorous sadhana under the tutelage of Shri Patnam Subramaniam Ayyar started. As we all know, Shri Vasudevacharya has composed a lot, many number of compositions and a variety of compositions. His compositions number close to around 200. And the varieties include Jatiswaras. There are 6 Jatiswaras that he has composed, 16 Varanas, 150 Kritis, 8 Ragamalikas, around 10 Tilanas, 6 Javanas, 1 Pada, 2 Bhajans. And the mudra or Ankita Nama that he has used is Vasudeva. And predominantly he has composed in Sanskrit and Telugu. And there's one composition in Kannada. We'll come to that a little later. So now let us listen to a Varana in the Raga Kannada set to Adita.
Ah,
Kavi Varna in praise of Lord Ganesha that he has composed in the Radha Kannada. Shri Mysore Vasudevacharya's Guru Bhakti was one of its kind. It was of the first order. He had a very tough routine in the Gurukula system under the able tutelage of Shri Patansubramanian Iyer. He would actually wake up at 4 in the morning, and from 4 to 6 he would play the tambura while his guru practiced, did a sadhana or taught the other students. And then there were other routine tasks that were allocated to him and all the other shishyas over there. All that would be done. And if the guru went for a walk, he would follow him. So literally he was like a shadow to his guru, Shri Patansubramanian Iyer. And all this guru seva would go on till almost 11 in the night. And only after the guru retired for the day would Shri Mysore Vasudevacharya also sleep. So this kind of sadhana went on for 6 months. And in this duration, he was not taught anything. Nothing for 6 months. Can you imagine a scenario wherein we go to a teacher and they're not taught anything? In fact, today in the situation of COVID, we are so fortunate to have online classes. We take classes on Skype, we go to classes, we attend classes from our gurus. They're so liberal, so lenient that they teach us on WhatsApp video calls, etc., using other technological aids. But in those days, for 6 months, the young Vasu was not taught anything. And only when the wavelength of the guru and shishya came to the same level, Shri Patansubramanian Iyer called him one day and told him that now you are ready to learn. And the first composition that he taught him was his own Varna in the Raga Bedara. And for almost 3 months, Mysore Vasudevacharya learned nothing other than the Bedara Varna. It was only the Bedara Varna, and all possible nuances of the Raga Bedara were taught to him. And this is how he learned under Patansubramanian Iyer for 6 long years. There is one composition in the Raga, Pushpalatika, which reflects the Guru Bhakti, the epitome of Guru Bhakti, Guru Bhakti Parakashta, as you can say, that Shri Mysore Vasudevacharya had towards his Guru. And again, there is a very interesting incident which led to the composition to be composed. There was one famous drama troupe called as Chamundeshwari Karnataka Nataka Sabha. But this drama troupe performed the Dana Shura Karna drama in Mysore, and Shri Vasudevacharya was a witness to it. He came home, it was almost 1 in the night. He kept thinking and he was pondering, and he was there was one thought that kept coming to his mind. Why is it that Karna, although was a better warrior than Arjuna, was easily defeated by Arjuna? The only reason that he could think of was Arjuna had the blessings of his guru, Shri Dronacharya. The guru bhakti that he had towards Dronacharya, he had the complete kataksha, guru kataksha of Dronacharya. Whereas Karna had the shapa of his guru Parushurama, who tells him when he comes to know that he had lied about his lineage, he curses him and says that at the appropriate time, when you want to recollect the mantra, you are going to forget it. And that is the downfall. So unfortunately, he forgets the mantra at the right time, which would have enabled him to invoke the weapons, and he may meet with death. So there is this composition. Immediately, Shri Vasudevacharya pens down this composition in the Raga Pushpalatika. I now sing this, and this is set to Trishra Rupa. Guru Kripaye लेख श्री हरि कृपा गुनगुना गुरु कृप लेख श्री हरि कृपा गुनगुना गुरु कृप लेख श्री हरि कृपा गुनगुना हरि मत में गुरु मत लेख श्री हरि कृपा गुनगुनाना हरि मत गुरु मत was in the year 1908 at the Shri Vidya Patashala. In fact, Shri Mysore Sheshanna presided over the entire function and also the concert, which lasted for around three and a half hours. And he was so overwhelmed, he was so happy, and tears were rolling down his eyes, and he literally presented him with a golden toda, a golden bracelet. Shri Mysore Vasudevacharya performed till the ripe age of 85, and he travelled all across India. He performed in Madras, in Bangalore, Coimbatore, Thiruvankur, Tiruchinapalli, Pune, Mumbai, Kolkata, Kolhapur, Baroda, Indore, Gwalior, Jalandhar, etc. He gave hundreds of concerts and several sabhas bestowed on him awards. He got not many number of awards. To mention a few, Sangeeta Kalaratna, Sangeeta Kalanidhi, Sangeeta Visharada, Ganacharya, Sarasagana Shiromani, Sangeeta Bhavagna Shikhamani, etc. And of course, the most important and most prominent award was the Padma Bhushana from the Government of India. As mentioned earlier, Shri Mysore Vasudevacharya has composed only one composition in Kannada, and there is a very interesting incident which led to the composition to be composed. Shri Nalvadi Krishnaraja Vadayar one day asked Mysore Vasudevacharya, when they were just conversing, why is it that although you are a Kannadiga, your mother tongue is Kannada, you have not composed any Kriti in the language Kannada? For this, Mysore Devacharya thinks for a second and he says, I have immense respect for my mother tongue, for my motherland. However, I don't have the fluency in the language to the extent that I can compose. I've always been a student of Sanskrit. I've studied Sanskrit language and I've followed the path of the great trinities. In fact, as we all know, Shri Mysore Vasudevacharya comes from the Shishya Parampara of Saint Tyagaraja, and he was thoroughly influenced by Shri Dikshitar also, Shrimati Swami Dikshitar. There is a lot of reflection that we can find when we unearth the technical details in his compositions. We'll come to it a little later, if time permits. So he says that I am not competent enough in the language to compose Kriti. However, Maharaja, since you have told me, I take it as an Adesha, and I am going to compose in the Raga Kannada. And there is one composition in the Raga, in the language Kannada, and there is only one composition in Saraswati Manohari, Karunisau Tai. Another very interesting fact is what led Shri Mysore Vasudevacharya to actually start composing, or what motivated him to start composing. In the 1900s, when the disease plague spread all over Mysore, there were hundreds of people who were dying and who were inflicted by this disease. That is when Shri Gopalaraja Aras, a very dear friend of Mysore Vasudevacharya's father, advised him that he should start composing compositions. And for this, Shri Mysore Vasudevacharya was very reluctant. He said that already the great trinities have composed so many compositions. There are hundreds of compositions that they have already composed. There's a rich legacy behind. And apart from that, there are so many other composers who have composed so many kriti, so many kirtanas. So what is the need for me to add to these compositions? In fact, one lifetime will not be adequate to learn these compositions and sing them. For this, Shri Gopalaraja says, today we are all there. We do not know what is going to happen tomorrow. So even after you are gone, what is always going to stay behind is the legacy that you left behind. Your compositions are going to stay for posterity, so you must start composing. And this is what motivated him to start composing. And the very first composition that he composed was in the Raga Maya Madhavaroda. And this is set to a tough Tala, which is actually the Mishra Champe Tala. Chintaye hum janaki kantam santatam chintaye hum janaki kantam santatam chintitarthadayakam anilat sutanutam kanti vichita diyapatim dayanvitam chintaye hum janaki kantam santatam chintitartha dayakam anilasutanutam kanti vichita diyapatim dayanvitam chintaye hum janaki having the Lord's name, that is Keshava, Narayana, Govinda, so on so forth. There is yet another very interesting incident that took place in his life. A very great Nagaswara Vidwan, Shri Madurai Ponnuswamy, came to Mysore once. He performed at the court of Mysore, the royal court. And after the concert, after the performance, he made a statement and said that Yes, we have the 72 Milakatarana scheme, which is a very useful one. However, 36 Milakarta ragas have no compositions in them. So, they are quite redundant. There is no use in having the 72 Milakarta ragas at all, except that it satisfies the scientific formula. Otherwise, what is the need for the 72 Milakarta ragas? The Maharaja listened to this. He did not say anything. And the next day, he invited all the Astana Vidwans to the court. And he narrated the entire incident and suggested to them that you must consider composing in the other 36 Milakarta ragas which do not have compositions in them. For this, immediately Bidaram Krishnappa said that there is absolutely no need for us to do this because our Mysore Vasudevacharya has already done the needful. And it is very interesting to note that Vasudevacharya has composed in rare ragams like Rishabhapriya, Bhavapriya, Kokilapriya, Natakapriya, Ramapriya, Dharmavati, Gamanashrama, Vakulabharana, Dhenuka, Latangi, Sarasangi, Gauri Manohari, Shubhapanthuvarani, Jharavarani, so on and so forth. As soon as Vadiyar got to know about this information, he immediately sanctioned grants and he said that all these compositions must be notated and they must be documented, and immediately he sanctioned funds for the Vasudeva Kirtana Manjari. That was a great gesture on the part of Vadiyar, which has given all the students of Carnatic classical music a great wealth to assimilate. In fact, a couple of compositions in the Rare Ragams, if you just have a look at the Pallavi quickly. In the Raga Natakapriya, just sing the Pallavi quickly so that you can cover more information.
ఇది సమయము భ్రోవ రాధా ఇది సమయము భ్రోవ రాధా యదు కుల తిలక ఇది సమయము భ్రోవ రాధా యదు కుల తిలక
composition in Gauri Manohari, which all students will know, all of us will
know. Varana Lakshmi Namo Stote Varade Nara Hari Sukhade Varana Lakshmi Namo Stote Varade Nara Hari Sukhade Varana Lakshmi Namo Stote Varade Nara Hari Sukhare Varalakshmi Namostute.
Why I took up this particular composition is, let us just quickly look at one or two aspects about the technicalities that we see in his Kritis and other compositions also. Now, if you take this particular composition, which is very popular, the concept of prasa can be very easily seen. Any student can recognize or identify the prasa, which is a very important part of rhetorics or prosody. Vara Lakshmi Namostate, Vara De Nara Hari Sukhade, Ra Ra.
Yeah.
senior most vidwans. He was asked to present his tribute to Saint Tyagaraja at the end. So as Mysore Vasudevacharya was listening to all the artists who were singing, an idea flashed to him. Extempore, he composed a composition in the ragam Kalyani, and when his turn came towards the end, just before the Mahamangalarti could happen, he sang this particular composition. Shrimadadi Tyagaraja Guruvar. Shrimadadi Tyagaraja Guruvar. Namamyaham. Shrimadadi Tyagaraja Guruvar. And in the Charana, there are almost 10 Sangatis. The vigorous composition, the way, the flow of the extempore, the flow of the composition was such that everyone was wondering, who's the composer? Because it was, nobody has heard that composition earlier, right? And finally, when the Ankitanama came, Vasudeva, they were all taken aback and, array, this is his own composition which he composed right at that moment. So that was the kind of Vagyayakara that Sri Mysore Vasudevacharya was. One of the tragic incidents that happened in his life was that he lost his wife, his dear wife, at a very young age of 40. That was a very big blow for him because he was just left with one son. And that is when, in immense grief, in front of the Lord, he composes this particular composition. And this composition is in the ragam Behag.
Vasavadisa
The ragam itself is like that, and this is apparently set to Khanda Triputa Tala. As I told you earlier, the selection of talas in Shri Mysore Vasudevacharya's composition is varied and complex. The Pallavi, so that we can go ahead. I think I have another 7 minutes left. Yeah, 8 minutes.
Mama Hridaye Vihar Dayalu. Mama Hridaye Vihar Dayalu. Krishna Mama Hridaye Vihar Dayalu. Krishna Mama Hridaye Vihar Dayalu. Krishna Mandara Dhar Govind Mukunda. Mama Hridaye Vihar Dayalu. Krishna Mandara Dhar Govind Mukunda. Mama Hridaye Vihar Dayalu Krishna.
Shri Mysore Vasudevacharya devoted his entire life only for music. In the year 1953, at the ripe age of 88, he was 88, very difficult and hard to imagine. That is when the great Rukmini Devi Karunde of Kalakshetra, she approached Mysore Vasudevacharya and requested him to come to Kalakshetra and guide the students there. So at that age, he made the transition from his hometown, his Janmabhumi, that place, Mysore, where he had lived his entire life, to Chennai. Can you imagine the kind of a transition at an age of 88? And for 7 long years, he relentlessly worked on the project Ramayana Nritya Nataka composition, which was in 5 parts. That is a very significant milestone in his musical journey. Another important fact when we analyze the compositions is that Mysore Vasudevacharya has not composed too many kritis in the Mishra Chapu Tala. The variety of talas, again going back to the tala concept, if my memory serves me right, there are only 4 compositions that he has composed, kritis, I'm talking about kritis, that he has composed in Mishra Chapu. So let's quickly listen to one composition. This is in the Raga Kamavardhini. Mm-hmm. This is one composition in the praise of Bhagavati. Of course, majority of his compositions are in the praise of Lord Rama, his Aradhya Deva. So we'll quickly go through this.
Shankari Ninne Shankari Ninne Ika Chala Nammi Deni Shankari Ninne
interacted with all his students, and then around 8:15 in the night he called his grandson Shri Raja Ram and told him to come and sing the composition Intha Prabhuva Kaanenu Ee Jagadode. As his grandson was singing, Shri Mysore Vasudevacharya made an effort to raise his head. He was lying down. He made a sincere effort to raise his head to listen to the divine nada of the tambura. It was that last effort, gradually listening to the beautiful, divine, soulful nada of the tambura, he breathed his last. Although Shri Mysore Vasudevacharya is no longer with us, he is no more, the rich legacy of compositions and his two very important works, one, his autobiography, Nenupugalu, and two, Naa Kanda Kalavidaru, have greatly enriched the musical wealth, the content of our Karnataka classical music. And before I conclude my lecture demonstration, I would like to present a crisp tilana, and probably I'll be taking another 2 minutes, Kanchana. This is again in a very rare raga called as Shuddha Sadavi, a janyam of the 22nd Melakarta raga, Kharhar.
Dhimta dhimta dhira nada.
தானே தோன்ற தரணின் தடதின் தான் நிறுத்த தேர்ந்தரிடன் அறிவு தானே தோன்ற தரணின் தரதின் தான் தேர்ந்த தோந்ததர தோந்தன ஜனுத தீர்ந்ததில்லானது தெரிந்தானது परम पुरुष श्री वासुदेव नीरजाक्ष परिपाहि माम परम पुरुष श्री वासुदेव नीरजाक्ष परिपाहि माम भारमार ननु प्रोवनीकु भवाप्ति तारक भुवन रक्षक भारमार ननु प्रोवनीकु भवाप्ति तारक भुवन रक्षक ताकिटतक धीकिटतक तोंतनु तर धीरन धित्तिलान निरना ताकिटतक धीकिटतक तोंतनु तर धीरन धित्तिलान निरना तक छुड़ छुड़ तक धिमिकिट किट धिमि धित्तिलान भवस धित्तिलान कुमरी तजुड़ सस सस छुड़ तम मम तक तक धिमि धिमि तक तक धिमिंत धिमिंत निरना निरदानी तोमिरदानी धीम तर धीम धीम तोंत नन तोंत न झणुता धीम तिल्लान दिदनानी तिल्लाना धीम तदेंत दिरनादी दानी तोंदतानी धीम तदेंत दिरनादी दानी तोंदतानी धीम तदेंत दिरनादी दानी तोंदतानी धीम दिरनादी दानी तोंदतानी धीम दिरनादी दानी तोंदतानी धीम तन धीम. With this, I would like to conclude my lecture demonstration. I would like to congratulate the entire team of Vagheyakara Vaibhavam for coming out with this brilliant idea to celebrate Shri Mysore Vasudevacharya Day. And I would also like to thank all of you for listening to me live and watching me live. And thank you to the entire team Vagheyakara Vaibhavam for having me here today. So, catch you later.